Hi everybody, I received a request from a client asking for help on modifying the CSS cascading style sheet for a template on a site that he is building. He is using a RocketTheme template, and I have a membership with RocketTheme.com. I really like their templates, I like their extensions, I like tons of features in them. One of the things that is super about them is they're really easy to modify the template itself by changing the CSS. It used to be very complicated. You had to go into the CSS files for within the template and find out where which specific line it was and fiddle around and change and test. Now it's way simpler, and so I want to just do this tutorial to show him and you how easy it can be, how easy it is to change templates when you're using RocketTheme templates. Here we are at the basic Joomla site. This is the default template that comes with Joomla. So I'm here in the back end. I'm going to go to extensions and template manager, and I'm going to select the Gantry template, which I have installed. This default one is free, and it comes with all of the extensions that are needed to run Gantry. And I'll put a link in the description for you to go and download what you need to do the same. So I'm just going to click here, make it the default, go back to the home page here, and refresh, and we'll see that the template has changed. And now we're set to try to change this template up. The client is wondering about how to change the heading 2 CSS value. Tag, that's right, it's a tag. And to do that, we're going to use a tool. I'm using Chrome right now. If I hit F12, it opens up these developer tools. And if I click on this magnifying glass down here, I can then highlight different parts of the template, and it will show me over here in the right-hand side which CSS is affecting that. So I'm going to just select the welcome header here. And when I click that, it changes, and we see all of the rules, with the beginning rules in the cascade, to the final ones that are affecting what is seen on the screen. So we see right here this welcome. The last thing affecting it is this hover color, which is black for link A hover. When I mouse over that, it turns black. Before that, the blue color that is assigned to the link, that is crossed out for the hover because something else is taken over in a different cascading style sheet. We can go further down and see all the different rules that are affecting it. Now the question here is how to change the size for this title. You know, see, title is the tag, and component content heading 2, and here we see font size of 28, line height 30, font weight normal, letter spacing normal. So to change, to preview the change to the size of that font, we could just click in here, and instead of 28, I'm going to get rid of that 2 and make it 58, and right away we'll see the letter change, the font changing in its size. Or we could go 108 and make it even bigger. Now let's suppose that is the size you want your coding to appear in a template. The title to appear in a template. Title, component, content, heading 2. Well, then you can copy these changes and paste them in a custom CSS page. So let's just leave this for a second, and we'll go and create that custom CSS page. It's super easy to do. So we're back in the back end of Joomla, and I'm going to go to where this custom CSS file needs to be put. And to do that, I'm going to use this component here called exTplorer. It's a file explorer for within your Joomla install. And here it shows the tree of your Joomla install. And what you want to do is go to the CSS folder for the template that you are modifying. So if I click on templates here, we see in this basic install, I've got B3, Gantry, which is the one that I've installed from RocketTheme.com, protostar, which comes with Joomla, and system. And I want to put, we're modifying Gantry, so we'll go into Gantry, double-clicking there. Going to go into the CSS folder, and here there are some files, depending on which RocketTheme folder that template you use, there will be more files here. But we want to make a file in this folder, and here's the formula for it. So I'm going to click here, new file directory, and I'm going to give it a name, and the taxonomy for the name is the template name, then dash custom.css. So this is template is actually named Gantry, and hyphen custom, and that is what we want that file to be. Now let's suppose that you have a template that's called Stratus. That's a RocketTheme template that's out right now. RT underscore Stratus would be the name of this custom CSS file. Of course, this file would have to go in the template folder for RT Stratus. So the name of the template here is Gantry, so we'll create it here. We click Create. And then next, what we want to do is right-click, and we'll edit that. Now, it's a blank file, of course. That's all right. We can head back to the home page where we have this title font select, the CSS for it. And I'm going to left-click, and I'm just going to drag and select all of that. And now I'm going to go Control-C for copy. I guess you could right-click and go copy as well. Now, let's go back to that custom file, and we'll paste in the CSS. Now the only thing that we've really changed in all of this is the size. We could change other things. We could change the font weight. We could even add a line for to change the color, but let's just keep it simple right now. So we don't really need this line height change or font weight because that's already active. We don't want to change that. We just want to be changing the size. So now I'm going to save that file. And we'll go back to the site here. I can even close this off for now. And I'm going to refresh the page. And we'll see on the refresh, the letters in that heading remain the same. So if I hit F12 again, use the magnifying glass, we can select that. Now when we go over, we see the CSS that is applied. And when we go down, we'll see that the size here is changed in this file, gantry-custom.css. So basically, if you can find the CSS that is affecting this this template and how it's displayed, find the code, copy it after you've made it look the way that you want it to, and then paste it in your custom CSS file. There is also a tool for Firefox. Let me just bring that over quickly. It's called Firebug. It's an extension that you would add on to Firefox. So search for that extensions and you turn that on also with F12. It has a different kind of it's not a magnifying glass, it's a square, but then once again you could click, and then down the right hand side you can see the CSS that is affecting that. Now this window, it's small because I haven't refreshed it since the last changes, so I'll refresh it and now it's big and looks the same. So let's drag that back over there. So that is a really super way to customize the RocketTheme templates and the CSS. It's much easier than trying to find out where the CSS was in everything else. I'll end up just by pointing this out, that here, this title, even though it is title and it's dot component content heading 2, you see down here, heading 2 itself for its font size has been taken over by this declaration farther up. That is heading 2. So if you want to change heading 2 throughout the site, if you're using heading 2 on a page, for instance, just in your content, what you would want to do is find a page with simple heading 2 where you want to change it, and select it, or you could even just do this. We'll just collect this canceled out part. We'll go over and I'll paste that in there. and we can say heading 2 is, it doesn't matter if I change this now because this one will take over in that position. But anywhere else that heading 2 showed up, it would be whatever size change. And that's just the basics for editing a template, changing the CSS on RocketTheme templates. And once you can change something like that, you get into much more complicated options if you want, and you can change all sorts of things in the menu, the font, the possibilities really open up. And thanks to the people at rockettheme.com, by using the template name dash custom.css file, you can change a lot of things really easier and have your way with the template, which is the way that Joomla is supposed to work. So I hope that helps you and encourages you in customizing your RocketTheme.com templates. If you have any questions, ask them on the page. And if you're interested in having any work done on your site, I'm available for hire as well. And with my membership for RocketTheme, I can use those templates on projects that I'm working on. So thanks for watching, and enjoy working on your website. God bless. Thank you.